See, you see a poop twice, but now there's four poops. So, the dragons are your new Fiomia. In fact, I'd say that they're... Look, it's just dropping deuces everywhere. It actually drops a deuce, too. It drops two poops at one time. It's amazingly funny. But, Hey there, folks. Mazion reporting for duty, and today I'm playing Ark Survival Evolved on the Pooping Evolved Scorched Earth server. And today, we're going to do a couple of things around the house. I want to show you guys first some changes that I've already made. So you can see I've made my porch a lot bigger, and there's a dino gate in here. I did all this stuff just while I was fub-dubbing around here. But, I mean, it's really not that useful since I can't get my parasaur in here. But, I mean, it's kind of nice to put the parasaur's foot here and be able to run in and out and do all the things that I gotta do. Plus, I put a vault in here. We've got a vault. It's right on this side. I am still considering putting a vault, like, right here in this area as well. And then having just regular storage for the rest of it. But then I've also made a chemistry bench. And I gotta tell you, it is super, super awesome and super, super helpful for Scorched Earth. If not for anything else, but the ability to do this. Look at the clay go! It's amazing amounts of clay happening! And it's happening super fast! Man, it's been such a pain in the butt. I was using these mortar and pestles outside here. These ones right here. And making 3,600 clay at a time. And it was a super duper duper pain in the butt. It was a really big pain. But now, you just get some cactus with your dragon. You get some sand with your rock golem. And then, oh my lord, it just keeps coming out, just pumping all kinds of stuff. And so, I am going to make today a greenhouse. And I'm going to make the greenhouse right over here. I'm going to either, I can't decide what I want to do. If I want to make it like a standalone and have it kind of face sideways-ish off of right here. Or what I was thinking about doing is using this platform and then bridging these ceilings all the way over to here. And then trying to make it kind of like a connected piece. It's something we're going to figure out today. I'm not really sure exactly which one I want to do. And I've been looking around for which one of these dinos is going to poop enough to make enough compost for me fast. And I found out which one it is. And it's not the one you would think. It is not the one you would think. It is the dragon. These dragons poop twice at a time. Not only do they poop twice at a time, but they're the only animal that I have that will actually poop from using stem berries. The other ones, you just feed them. See, you see a poop twice, but now there's four poops. So, the dragons are your new Fiomia. In fact, I'd say that they're... Look, it's just dropping deuces everywhere. It actually drops a deuce, too. It drops two poops at one time. It's amazingly funny. But, So this is what you're going to be using on Scorched Earth to make all the poopy. Look at all the poopy! So, yeah, it's pretty amazing, actually. I'm not just super excited. It is actually really super awesome. Gotta make sure that you have enough meat to feed it so that it can get itself back up, which I do not right now. It's going to need some food and soon. Well, I need to fill up these compost bins down here so that when we're ready with the greenhouse, we can actually put the crops out that we want to put out. I think that's enough poop. Oh, crap. Well, I probably could bring you down here anyway, Nuria, couldn't I? Because we're going to have to get you some meats. Oh, man. I am stuck inside, Nuria. It's not good. So, yeah. Dragons are the new Fiomia for poop. Just going to fill these guys right up so that we can have some fertilizer when the time comes. Although, I have already made some preemptively. So that we'll be all set when the new... Open sesame! When the new garden is made. So we've got, you know, a little bit of poop already. Plus, I've got all the wood and stuff. I'm going to put the heavier stuff in this vault. The wood, the stone. We've got stone over here. But I need to make ceilings. So I have only learned the greenhouse ceilings because I decided what I was going to do is I'm going to make... You know, I think I needed more metal. I'm going to make the structure out of adobe. It's going to be an adobe greenhouse with glass ceilings is what I'm thinking about doing here. I think 20 ceilings is going to be plenty enough. And so I'm not going to make a... I'm going to make it flat. It's going to have flat ceilings. So I haven't really decided how tall or how wide I'm going to make the building yet. That's something I'm going to start working on here in just a moment. But I do know that we're going to make an adobe structure, and we're going to have a composting area over there. And I want to talk to you guys a little bit about the plans, the building plans that I have coming up too. I want to build a weird, I shouldn't say weird, I want to build like a grandiose dragon roost on top of that stone way up there. You see where all my, you see my dragons are way up there on top of that thing? I want to build like a roost up there where there's like multiple pads or something for dragons to come and land on. Dragons are super, super pain in the butt to land on anything though. And I can show you in just a second. We probably have done this in the past. I need some meat so that Nyria doesn't starve to death. But if I want to land on this pad here, A, I can't be flying fast. B, I have the best luck when I fly at an angle to the pad. C, you have to get super lucky. Like, I just hit the button and hope that it works, and it did this time. But it's a 5x5, and I still have a lot of trouble landing these dragons on there. It's super, super pain in the butt. And so I want to make a new area up there for my dragons to land. I also want to have the greenhouse made down here, and we also are going to need some sort of housing for dinos. I need a new mantis. I would like to get a mantis that I can only put weight in, because they are awesome. Awesome at gathering wood and flint. They're really, really great, and I've done Ankies many, many seasons, Dodicarus many, many seasons. And so this season, I'm thinking no Dodicarus, no Anky. That's it. We're done. We're going to make an awesome mantis for that stuff. And we've got Behemoth here who takes care of all of our rock and sand needs. He can get everything that we need. It's amazing, and it makes nonstop rocking possible. All right, so I'm going to get together and get... This has been a pain too, by the way. You're having to repair this generator every day. I'm going to get together the materials that we need to make the greenhouse, and we'll be right back with you to build it. So I made an alteration to the plan. What I did instead was I came and I modified my dock. I made my dock come out much, much farther here so that you can still have like an area to fish or whatever on this side. And I'm going to put the greenhouse right here. So you can, I'm probably going to make an area to get up to it from the side here too. And it's going to be in the center, which is going to be a really big pain in the butt, I just realized, because we're going to have to put the walls between two ceilings in the middle, which is always a super, super fun time. Is it going to be on this one or that one or this one or that one? I think we're going to put it on the inside one like that. Oh, what the crap? See, this kind of crap is annoying. It makes it difficult to build between the ceilings when you do this. Is that gonna work? Cool. So that should be on the appropriate one there. And it's gonna have an entire area around it where we're gonna end up putting the compost at. So there should be another like a so, and then over here like a so, just like that. We need a doorway, and then a doorway. Like so. Yep, it's working out so far. So it's going to be 5x3. 5x3. It's a little bit bigger than it needs to be, but I always like to allow room for expansion. I think it's important to be able to expand if you want to. Uh-oh. Sandstorm's coming. Is that right? Cool. Keep it up with the easy placement, please. Oh, yeah. Oh no! Stupid wall! Everything was going so good until you came along! Alright, so let's see. You're gonna be right? Sweet! And then maybe you'll be right too. Oh yeah! That's right! Things are going good. Ah! Curses! Ark building! Yay! Yay! Once we get the bottom floor done, like the ground level, it's all gravy after that. Okay, cool. So we're just gonna have this little 5x3 area, and I'm gonna have the ceiling be the greenhouse stuff. So that what that means for us now is we gotta decide where our crop plots are gonna go, and if we're gonna have anything else on the inside of the building, which I think I'm going to have a large storage box or two in there to hold fertilizer. Bam. So let's go right into the corner here. One. Come on. What's your problem? What's it obstructed by? There's no obstruction. Weird, man. That's weird. Is it obstructed by the other crop plot? It's weird, man. It shouldn't be doing that. It is. Interesting. Usually, you used to be able to overlap these pretty good. But, so I think I'm just going to put these in a straight line. I think we're just going to straight line up in this place. These crop plots. One more. Oh, oh, something like that. Doesn't need to be super pretty. Oh, in fact, it's not pretty. In fact, it's not pretty. But now, we just got to put up the rest of the walls here. I don't know if I brought enough. We're going to have a sandstorm. We're racing against the sandstorm. Give me my walls. Oh, thank you very much. Should be able to put the rest of this up. I've been considering putting in some greenhouse walls as windows in this place as well. I think we're just going to do it the two high like this. Nighttime is coming. A sandstorm is coming. If we do it too high like that. Yeah. It should allow for expansion. You see. Put you in here. And then I should have 20 of the greenhouse ceilings out here. Racing against the sandstorm. Here we go. And oh no, the sandstorm's here. So what I was thinking about doing was putting a railing around the top for aesthetics. Now, I'm not sure how exactly it's going to look, but we're going to try it because I've never done it before. And if I do I have my door on me? Boom! So I shouldn't be in the sandstorm, right? No sandstorm here? Sweet! That's exactly what we wanted. So we've got only 4 crop plots right here. I decided to go with 4 because what I usually do is put down 6 and then not use 2 of them. So I thought today we'd start with 4, and then if I decided I wanted more, we would go on from there. But do I have... I do have everything to tap in on me. Let's see how this goes real quick. It's dark. Gamma 4. 4. Gamma 4. We're going to go out. We're going to work in the sandstorm. Oh, man. So what I think I can do probably is place the tap first. I think I could place the tap first. I think this will work out. So what I'll do is I'll place the tap. Oh, no. No, we can't place the tap first. And so if I want to place the vertical pipe, that won't work either. So we got to place the... Oh, man, this is going to be difficult to figure out. Check it out. 1 wall, 2 walls. And then so between the first 2 walls, which would be the first 2 ceilings, which is actually the third ceiling. So right here-ish. Oh, man. What a pain in the butt. Right here. Should be able to place the intake down. I can't see. Thank you. Oh, man. So if I place it, like, I'm going to just go with it. I'm just going to, oh, no. Oh, no. It's too short. Let's go see if it irrigated that stuff. That would be amazing if it actually irrigated everything that up in there. Come on, irrigation. It is irrigated. Check it out, man. Perfect. Everything is irrigated. Okay, so that is what we needed. So now we're going to get some crops placed down in here, get some storage in here, and then what I think we're going to do is go see if we can find ourselves another mantis. We're back, and it's done. There it is. It's early morning, so we got the game up a little bit. I've got these compost bins all out the back here. I threw a bunch of poop on the ground because we got an area over pooping. But all this is ready to make all kinds of more fertilizer. We've got those up on the regular porch in the front. And then you go on here. We've got 1 storage bin for now. And we've got our crops seeded and ready to go. So everything is all set up to have the farm for the kibble. Not that we're going to need a lot of kibble here. But we do definitely want to have kibble for our rock golems. We want to get a perfect rock golem tame at some point here. All right, and I don't think I mentioned that we got a grill that we did on stream here. We got a grill there and a millet made a fridge, and so we've got all kinds of meats now, and we got a place to store all of our other stuff, including our level 120 fertilized wyvern egg. So It is time to go out. Oh, you know what? I need to get the things necessary and to go out and find ourselves a mantis. We need a mantis. You know what I don't have? Oh, crap. I need at least, we'll grab twice as many as we need just in case. They're so heavy. But I need to have insect repellent if I'm going to tame something really high, or rather if I'm going to tame one at all. But we're going to go find ourselves a mantis to do some of the work around here, and I'm going to need to make some bug repellent to do so. All right, I'm out in the desert, and I found a 104, and I'm just kind of gallivanting around it, destroying all the things in the immediate area, and make sure a death worm doesn't show up and try to eat me. But yeah, we're just kind of cleaning things up. I think a 104 will do fine for the purpose that we're gonna utilize it for, which is just strictly gathering. Gonna just pump a crap load of weight on it. So there we go. I think it's good to go. Now I should just be able to take my bug repellent, leave my dragon over here. Oh, Jerby. Hang out with the dragon, Jerby. Now we should be able to do what we need to do. It should be no problem at all. But, you know, these mantis, they're very glitchy. Glitch mantis. Like this one. This one that won't let me feed him. It's glitchy. Now he's attacking me. So, you know what's probably going to happen is we're probably not going to be able to tame this one due to the glitchiness. Oh, man, it's going to beat the crap out of me, too. So, we're going to take off. See if we can reset it. And if we can, we'll try to tame it. But we probably won't be able to at this point. It looks like it is not tameable. It is still chasing me. There. Now it has given up. Pretty sure we are not going to be able to tame this thing now. Oh, crap. What are you doing? Stop, dragon. Stay. Gah! Why did they make F the same thing? It's stupid. And there's a vulture out here. Kill the vulture. Kill it. All right, you got it. So the scorpion shouldn't bother us at all. But you see how the mantis is no longer moving? Just kind of standing there? Seems to be what they do when they glitch out. Oh, no, it's moving now. Moving pretty fiercely. Can we tame you? Okay. Oh, we can! I fed it a horn! It's been fed a horn! It's amazing. Alright, so hopefully we'll get the other couple feedings into it and be good to go. I'm burning alive, but it's the last feeding. Bam, and we're gonna call this guy Aikido. Following our martial arts theme, we've got Aikido. And Aikido's got 990 health. It's got 334 weight, 290% melee damage, 167% movement speed, and we're gonna pump the crap out of that way. But first, the thing is first, we gotta get back to the dragon, and we gotta bring this thing back home and get a saddle for it so we can train it up, see what kind of weight we can get up on it. Oh man, look, it's so far away. Come on, Aikido. Uh-oh. This is gonna be a fight. Maybe not. I've done a ton of leveling on it already. I just went out and went ham after we got it back home and killed a bunch of parasers and other things. And so now we're gonna see how much weight we can get per tick. Ooh. Not very much, just like 26 per-ish. But what do we get total? 575 weight total so far. Now, if you remember, a Dodicarus. Bam! 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 Get him! Bam! Yes! Limantria thwarted! If you remember, Dodicarus have really, really low starting weight. Like, really, really bad. Now, I've got 290 melee damage on Aikido, and I think I've got way, way, way more down here. On Kung Fu. Kung Fu, come here, Kung Fu. Kung Fu's rocking like 829%. Now, when I put an axe on Kung Fu and I chop a certain tree around here, I get 900 wood. So we're going to go try to chop that same tree. I'll show you where it is. And we'll see if we get 900 wood from the chop or how much less it's going to be based on the melee damage, if any at all. But we'll find out once I get to the tree. There is the 900 tree. This tree gives 900 wood. Now, 261. Wrong tree. These small trees right here give a lot of wood when you chop them. 324. 349. So it doesn't look like, it looks like the melee damage difference does make a big difference. We'd have to try more trees like that. So 319. Try you. Choppa! 364. Choppa! 374. We are able to get a lot of wood consecutively. We can carry more wood, but I think I need to get the weight up quite a bit more. So we're looking like to get it up to like 1,000-ish weight. And then perhaps be able to do some serious gathering with it. Now, you know as well that the thorn dragons are good for that too. So the thorn dragons might be the better choice for wood, especially with the low weight. But I am. Flint gatherer. Amazing flint gathering skills on these guys. But it looks, again, like we'd want to have melee damage raised. We can get all kinds of flint really quick around here on them. Obviously gathering sand as well. But look at that. We could go out and really do a number on the flints. Choppa. Which, yeah, I mean, even just that's worth it. Check it out, man. That's a lot of flint. That's a lot of flint really fast. Wait up. And so I've got some things that I want to do with the next episode or in an episode very soon. We're going to keep working on Aikido and getting its weight up. Just not today. But if you go up in here, I have upstairs, I've got a Mastercraft flamethrower blueprint, which I'm really excited to try out. We've got homing rockets, which we haven't tried out yet. And I actually got a apprentice flamethrower from a drop. And so we're going to have to make... Boom. First, we're going to have to make propellant, which requires oil, cactus sap, and sulfur. And then we have to make... No, it's under here. Weapons, ammo. We have to make the flamethrower ammo, which requires gasoline and propellant. So... It looks like gunpowder isn't required at all, which, you know, makes the flint gathering kind of moot unless we're making those homing rockets, in which case we're going to need lots and lots of gunpowder. Lots of gunpowder. 50 gunpowder per. 5 electronics, 20 metal ingots, 15 polymer, 40 cementing paste, and 20 crystal per homing missile. It's going to be really, really fun and really interesting to get that going. But we did some cool stuff today. We got ourselves the new greenhouse, and things are sprouted. Look at this. It's amazing. Oh, I don't have any plants yet, but I'm pretty happy with the greenhouse. I like the area it's at, and I actually flew in. We got any more? Yeah, we've got more fertilizer. I actually flew in from, where's my dragon? There's my dragon from away, and I think it looks pretty cool how the base is developing. Looking pretty good. I can imagine it getting bigger and having more stuff. And being a little bit more spread out here. But I like the look of it. It's different. I usually do these giant builds, but not today. Not this season. We're doing something a little bit different, and I'm enjoying it. Hope you guys are too. Hope you guys enjoyed today's episode. If you did, make sure you blast the like button. Don't forget to subscribe. And as always, be excellent to each other. Have a great day. See you later.